Hey guys, this is Shinx and we are back in another One Piece Bounty Rush video. So before I want to start this video right, I want to tell you guys about my giveaway in case you guys still don't know. Basically I'm doing a giveaway for hitting like 175 subs. So to enter the giveaway, you just have to look into my giveaway video. And basically I'm giving away 3 times $10 Google Play or iTunes gift cards. So the way to enter the giveaway is very simple. So yeah, do check it out. And today I want to showcase a bit of the kit which I actually got from the legendary ticket. So this kit, this banner is actually still ongoing. So I just want to let you guys know. I know this video is kind of late, but basically I want to showcase him, whether some of you, if you guys still want to go for him, etc. He's actually a very, very strong character. Like, if you can 5-star, even 6-star him, he's actually very god. So, yeah, stats-wise, at 4-star, which is the only level I can get, he's a blue attacker, by the way. So, 4-star, he has 4,200 HP, 1,000 attack, which is okay, because pretty nice, because some 4 stars only had like less than 1000, so yeah. Defense 879, 7% crit. So skill 1, attract. So it puts the character in a buff state. So when his buff state, attack is increased and character becomes immune to status effects, but loses the ability to capture treasure. So the buff state will be removed after receiving a certain amount of damage or using a skill. Okay, so basically this skill is like, if you haven't seen it, it's basically he starts attracting all the metals and he gets like these two huge hands, which I believe will increase his range of his normal attacks. Like, it sounds pretty cool, like, to be honest. And at he has a cooldown of 30 seconds at level 5. So unlock condition, this means that basically if he receives 30% of damage of his max HP, it will cancel the buff effect, I believe. So yeah, very, very cool skill. I believe, right, like, what I want to test out is basically how a 4-star with max attack as possible, right, can potentially be a 5-star with his skill 1. So yeah, that's what I want to test it out. So this is his next attack. So it's a repel, so it's a long range attack, definitely a plus. In buff state, damage dealt will be increased and the buff state will be removed. So basically what you want to do is you want to be in buff state because when you want to use these skills, because of how good the combo between these two is. Like, at normal state, right, your attack is only 566 at level 5, but in buff state, right, you are at 858. And not only that, you gain a knockback effect of at buff state also. So with buff state, right, you can get not only a high damage, plus you can knock away the enemies. So it's insane, this skill, and it only has a cooldown of 18 seconds, which is like mind blown. So team boost, attack boost, traits, skill 1 boost, when using skill 1 boost speed by 30%. Very, very sweet, because a lot of the cases where I find it hard to chase after people. Like, when they start running away, right, impossible, man, just give up. Then next will be when your strength is more than 70%, reduce damage by 30%. This is a very strong trait because it helps his skill 1, like, how to say, because you receive lesser damage, right, your skill 1 is harder to be broken. So yeah, if I'm not wrong, that's what it means. So if I say some stuff wrong or what, I haven't really played him, to be honest, so it's like a fresh review. Okay, so his skill 2, trait 2, when you KO an opponent, reduce cooldown time of skill 1 by 30%. very very nice skill, because sadly I didn't have him, but it makes him like the 30 million Luffy, the time skip Luffy, the Mihawk, where you can spam a lot of your skills. And with Kid, you basically just want to keep staying in your buff state as much as possible. Yeah. So next will be in the when in area around your captured treasure, boost cooldown or speed by skill 2 for 50%. This is very very good because your skill 2 will only cost like what, 9 seconds instead of 18 seconds if you are at level 5 lah. So he is a god. Like, I'm just gonna say this, he is so freaking good. Like, even the time skip Luffy that is gonna come out tomorrow, right, is nothing compared to this guy, I believe. Like, really man, just summon for him. He's like what you want. Like, as a 4-star, right, he's so good. And like, yeah, I believe like even at 4-star, right, I will not lose to the freaking 5-star peoples. So yeah. So okay, this will be my attack build, my standard full attack build. 60% attack and 160 attack stat. So yeah. Only about 1800, but if I'm not wrong, his buff in attack is actually what, how many? At least 10%, I would say. So they didn't really say, so it's okay. Next will be my support. So I will have 110.6% base boost in stat, which is not so much. Like, if you take a look at my support character, you're like, you'll be like, what the hell are you doing? Like, why are you using all these characters? I mean, like, you can see that there's red characters, there's blue characters, there's green characters. And like, what the, okay, yeah, so here is what am I gonna explain. So what am I gonna do, what am I trying to achieve is these two effects. So first one, attackers, I wanna get the, it's at level 5 at the moment, I get a boost of 200, which is very nice because it brings me to about 2k attack. Then it gives me a crit damage, which is also very nice. Okay, so the next one is East Blue. So increase damage to enemies with the same element by 15%. This makes him like viable even against the own element, which is very very nice because how to say, essentially you are making your blue element allies, your enemies, like how to say, okay, let me rephrase what I say. So you are making you versus blues the very similar to you versus red. So yeah, then blue attacker, he's actually blues are now not as viable as it is last time. As you know, last time there was a shit ton of red characters and like pretty much it's just red everywhere, so blue is like pretty much very very good, but it's still one of the very decent elements now. So yeah. Oh god, 3 bots each. Wait, is that 4 bots? Oh yeah, 3 bots each. So okay, now there's still a lot of red characters, but definitely you'll see much more blue characters or even green characters, which you have to watch out lah. So just take note of it. So I haven't tried him yet, so I want to try this thing. So I want to go to his buff state and run and charge all the way to the treasure. Like, does it do it that way? Yeah, I hope it works, man. Ooh, actually it works. Oh shit, yeah, I cannot capture. Oh my god, oh my god. Ooh. What the hell? Oh my god, I lost. Come on, lol, get back. Okay, I don't know you're capturing it. I totally forgot that I cannot capture the flag, man. Like, you remember, that's what I always like to do. Like I always go to the middle and I totally forgot about that. Does it? Oh, I don't even recover treasure amount. Oh wait, the buff is only a while. That's interesting. So yeah, holy shit, I actually do a lot of damage at this stage. Damn. It's actually damn good. Is anyone sneaking? Pyong. Oh, 6,000. That's actually damn insane. Oh, I see you sneaking, you useless. You think I don't know, huh? Lol, you damn you. I'm just gonna destroy you. Oh my god, I just two hit him, eh. Even though he's like, oh my god. Should I go kill him? No, oh yes, I killed him also. Ups la me. Five, four, two, one, and I won. Oh my god, this character is insane. Like, holy shit. Like, normally I don't like doing 4-star character reviews because of how their stats and their traits is not as good as the okay, so basically, what I was about to say is, like, you saw my chopper video, like, 4-star, I find it very hard to play against 5-star characters because of how the lack of traits, then the, what else is there? The lack of traits and the lack of stats. So yeah, but it's not the case for this kid. As you can see, I'm pretty sure the lore is a 5-star lore. And I'm in my buff state, I'm actually doing a lot of damage. So he's really really strong at, even at 4-star. Like, I might even consider using him. Like I feel like if you get him to 5-star, right, you should be really 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 happy. Because you essentially just got a free 6-star, I would say. Oh my god, it's him again. Oh, he saw me using it and he wanna use it. No, he saw me wrecking him. Oh my god. Try. So, okay, so I totally forgot about that. So my stand now is probably, oh my god, what is this sensitivity? I wanna, oh shit, no. Oh, he hit me with that. Oh. So I wanna wait for this Mihawk. Okay, so without his buff state, right, his attack range is actually very little. So obviously you wanna stay in your buff. Oh my god, you do like so much damage. Damn. What the hell? Why is someone there? Oh wait, no. That's actually a 5-star croc. Should I fight him? I feel like I want to wait until my buff state. Let me just help out. Okay, buff state. Get that Usopp who's trying to backcap. You think you can run? Huh? Huh? Yeah, look at that damage though. I feel like I just want to just stay in my buff state. Like, he can't even fight me. Luminous, oh my god. Okay, I'm in love with him. Like, come on. You think you green character, you big is it? Oh my god, he even pushes him away. Damn. Aye, hey, you think you can win? Come on. Oh wait. Oh my god, he's just too good. Look at that damage. Oh my god. Ooh. Haha, you think you can do it? Oh, you swap place with me. Ooh, that nice perfect dodge though. Ooh, I got destroyed. But I destroyed him, did I? No, I didn't destroy him. Okay, damn it. Well played, well played. Okay, switch to a Kainu. Just for the sake of. I wanna get that flat. Bet you didn't see that coming, did you? Ooh, baby. Ha, what's up? You think you're coming? Think I'm gonna let you get the flat easily? Like, his buff state, right? He can do as much damage as a Kainu, eh? Like, this is really insane, eh? Like, holy. Nice lah, guys. Good job, team. Like, I never felt this much pleasure playing 4-star characters before. Like, okay, just now that, Mihawk, right? I screwed up. Like, I know that for a fact that. Okay, basically, I misjudged my. I was just spamming my normal attacks. I should have closed in on him and before he even. I will kill him before he even casts his that skill. Then basically that was a misplay for my part. But damn, he's such a good character. Like, I feel like with that attacker plus East Blue character type effect, right? He's invincible. Oh my god, look at the amount of reds on the field. Looks like I'm gonna have a fun. Okay, if you guys are asking why, like thinking why am I using a Kainu instead of Usopp, the reason is because like blue character, right, supposedly if I get severely outnumbered by green characters, I can switch to my Kainu to counter them. So that's what my plan is, but guess not. Looks like I'm just gonna go on a killing streak. Yeah, like to be honest, the what's that. The range plus on his buff state is so nice, man. Oh my god. Ooh, baby. You think you can hit me? Come on. Team, you gotta get the flag. Leave the killing to me. Ooh. Oh my god, you saw, I was actually like pressing it then. Like I wanted to press it so bad. Hey, Usopp, what the hell are you doing? You think I never see you? Oh damn, that Usopp actually dealing quite a lot of damage. No. Oh my god, no, team. You. Not bad. Do you think I can cast my this effect? Then cast my skill? Okay, never mind. I screwed up, kind of. Okay. I see that Usopp coming. Haha! The moment you saw me, you run away, Lamau! Screw you, Usopp! Oh my god, I actually did like so much damage. No, I pressed the dodge. Oh, damn it. Okay, I'm having like a lot of loads of fun playing this character. Like, I'm pretty sure I'll lose, but come on, man. Okay, buff myself. Come on, stop them from getting the treasure, you useless. Damn, you guys. Holy shit, okay, I thought the animation was dead already. Okay, so definitely I screwed up. Oh my, because the I feel like, okay, I could have done a lot better because the thing is, like, I felt like I was doing okay. Like, my damage wise, I was inputting quite a lot of damage, but it's just I believe my teammates there was quite a lot of bots or something. So bots being bots, they don't know how to capture the flag. I'm just gonna say this straight. They suck so bad. Like they were all gathering at that spot. Like what the hell are they even doing? Okay, so yeah. It's just a mini rant, so obviously I screwed up a bit because I was just too excited, like going ham with his attack. Like I really love him so much. Like I feel like I wanna try. I'm just gonna keep summoning for that while the banner is active if possible. Look at the wow rates again. Oh my god. Okay, the thing is now there's also so many bots. So I'll just see if how much I can do. Okay, then one more thing about bots now is if you do not know bots, they will easily perfect dodge you if you don't use your skill properly. If you don't normal attack like properly, they can easily perfect dodge you and destroy you. So yeah. Come on. Okay, maybe I'm not as fast as the. Oh my god, holy shit, that's a lot. No! Okay, I should have went for that. The Zoro instead. Because, as you can see, he was doing a lot of damage when he's at the back. So yeah, I was like thinking whether I should go for the Zoro. Like okay, he's actually quite a lot of threat. So yeah, I like his skill one a lot. It's no joke. Then like with his traits that help him in his skill one, right? What the hell was that? Die. Okay, so I just wanna cast my skill. It didn't do a lot of damage, but I mean it's better than nothing. Oh shit, man, I wanna run. What the? Oh my god, I got destroyed by the Mihawk. Okay, I wanna switch off because I will lose again. Die, just die already. I hate you, Mihawk. Come on, this is the comeback. Hey, stupid! Can't you even get the flag? Damn you guys. Get the flag! You're useless! Get the flag! Oh my god, bots! I freaking hate bots, like really. Look, he didn't even support me having the flag. Developers of One Piece Donkey Rush, please make your bots to be smarter. Thanks, appreciate it. Oh no, you see, been more people backcapping. Like nobody's business. Oh. I don't care. Most likely I'll lose, but let me just try my best. Oh, actually I will win. Ha! You think you can treat me this time, huh? Useless Zoro. Just die already. Okay. Oi! Oh my god! The bots though. Damn! Okay, so I lost. I definitely wasn't doing bad at all. Like, I'll just say this straight, but bots being bots sucks. Okay, so I had a lot of fun playing this character. Definitely no regrets getting him. Like, at first I wanted Law because was it Law? Like, actually I wanted Law 5 star because of his runner abilities. Like I feel like he's the currently the best runner, but now that I actually played Kid, right, like that was my genuinely the first time I'm playing him. I had a lot of fun playing him, and he's such a good character. Like I feel like he's the best character One Piece Bounty Rush ever released. Like, as a 4-star character, he can easily stand up against 5-star. And that's not anything, and that's like, usually that's not what you wanna, like, that's not what the game wants, because they don't want to release a 4-star character that can trash a 5-star character. But that's not the case for this character. This character, in his buff state, he can just wreck everything. You just need teammates that is smart enough to capture the flag. And just now, right, if he actually helped me capture the flag, I could have definitely done more damage. So yeah, so this Kid at 4-star, he's already very, very, very good. At 5-star, he's just gonna do even more damage because of his cooldown reduction traits. Like, you can easily get into buff mode and debuff mode, buff mode and debuff mode. And like, I feel like if I have him at 6-star, right, my 20% cooldown reduction for skill 1, right, it's just gonna make him insane. Like, if you have him at 6-star, right, lucky you, you can just beat the whole game already. Like, unless he will be at the top of the tier list for at least a good 2 or 3 months, or maybe even all the way. Like, actually 2 or 3 months is pretty good already. Like, yeah, he's definitely one of the best characters that I've played so far, and 100% I'll guarantee you guys get him. Like, if you see the previous video that I posted, regarding the Luffy, right, now that I've played him, right, Luffy 4-star isn't even worth comparing to Kid 4-star, to be honest. So yeah, that's it for this video. I can go on for days, like, just saying how good is his character. But in his buff state, his attack animation range, right, from his normal, without buff state, is actually shit, to be honest. But at his buff state, he has so much range. Like, you can reach the enemy first before he can even whack you. Yeah, so the speed buff, definitely very useful. Just take note that don't be like me and forget that you cannot capture flag, and you cannot boost the treasure god, treasure gauge. So please take note of that. But other than that, he's a wonderful character, 10 out of 10 everything. And I think that's it for this video. If you want to see more weekly One Piece Bounty Rush or Bleach Mobile 3D videos, do consider subscribing to my channel and participate in my giveaway if you want to have a chance in getting more gems, maybe for this Kid, hopefully. Just a joke. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.